All right, been running this deep freezer all night with this new thermostat, and it has maintained about 34 degrees inside the deep freezer. The reason why I put a digital thermometer on here was to make it, or basically make it a refrigerator. But the good thing is that you can, it's a twofold, if you want to use it as a deep freezer, you can still use it as a deep freezer because you can just adjust the temperature down, which is really cool. So what I did is I ripped out the old panel here that was on the front and just rewired it. Now, this is for entertainment purposes only. If you're not sure what you're doing, hire or call an electrician or a buddy who knows what they're doing. I'm not going to be liable for any damage or injury that you do to yourself or your own equipment. So, for what it's worth, this is how I did it. Okay, $13 on Amazon. The way I have it wired, this is the line in. Hot goes here, neutral goes here. Then all the neutrals are tied together for the compressors. Three wires coming out of the compressor here. So I tied the neutrals together. And then the line here, or I'm sorry, the hot feeds over to this pin over here on the far left, and then this acts as a switch. This is the cooling. It's marked cooling, heating. You don't use heating for this application. You just want to switch cooling, and then the hot lead for the compressors right here. That goes in there. Pretty simple, straightforward. And then this little wire here is what it came with a temperature sensor probe wire. And I tried to put it inside the original hole, as you can see right there, and that didn't work out too good. So what I had to do is just run the wire on the back side of the freezer here and put it on the inside. Excuse me, little allergies. So basically, I just, insulation tape sensors right here. Works fine. And then just for giggles, I put two temperature things in here just to see how good this thing is cooling. The one on the bottom is 33, and the little sensor probe right here is 32. Perfect. And it didn't blow up my Mexican Coke bottle with real sugar, not that high fructose crap. So there you have it. I'll probably use some RTV silicone adhesive and cut out that and then mount that back on there. It'll look good. All right. There you have it. The reason why I'm doing this is to save energy. For one, digital is better. And the little college one I have over here is making some weird sounds, so this thing will keep things a lot cooler because cold air sinks. Cool. I'll do a system overview of this rewire probably next week sometime. Just want to get some miles behind it. But essentially what I did is start from the top and work my way down. All the solar panel wires are now in conduit going into this box here. All non-polarized breakers wired correctly, verified with three different companies and an electrical engineer. And I called my electrician and check my county for permits and inspection. And the electrician said, "You are good to go." There you have it. Basically everything's ready. This is 4-aught. I use THHN wire. in there, but it's never run better. Okay, there you have it. Thanks for watching.